Hello everyone, this is Nancy. Welcome back on my channel. Today I have something special for you, a Lanvin Fans summer video hop with a talented group of crafters who are all Lanvin fans. We are each sharing a Lanvin creation with the theme of summer. This is our second hop with each other and I'm so happy I'm participating in this awesome group. This hop is being sponsored by Not Too Shabby. Leave your comment for a chance to win a $25 shopping spree to their shop. It's open internationally and we announce the winner on August 6th. At the end of the description box, you can find all the Lanvin summer hoppers who are participating in this hop. To create this magical castle, I used only Lanvin products for today. I used the Unicorn stamp and die set, the Crazy Antic stamp and die set, the largest and the second largest die from the large slimline dies, the Build the Castle, the Meadow Grassy Borders and the Starry Sky stencil. Off camera, I already stamped my images with jet black ink on Nina Solo White cardstock. I'm not showing you all the coloring since it's gonna be a long video. You can see the coloring of one unicorn, the ball with cupcakes and the crazy antics. Next, I took the Build a Castle die cuts and put some purple tape on it to hold still while I'm ink blending. I used the Starry Sky stencil to create some interest on the castle with filtered violet stars and dots. Next, I'm adhering all the pieces together to create this magical castle. As you can see, I always change my mind when I'm crafting. I always start with a plan and that plan always changing during the process. I can't help it, it's just the way I craft. I saw the idea of doing the inside of the flags like this at Leontine from Little Lovely Crafts. I thought that was a very useful idea. Next, I'm ink blending this background. This will be the main panel. I use Distress Oxide inks, Peacock Feathers, Picket Raspberry and Filtered Violet. When I'm using Distress Oxide inks, I use my Taylor Expression brushes. Since I use these brushes, I attempt to make more custom ink blending backgrounds. I speed up the video for you, otherwise it will be a long video to watch. When I'm done ink blending, I use my paintbrush with water to make some splatters on my card. I use the paper towel to absorb the excess water. For some extra interest, I use some Gunsign Tembi paint to make some glittery and colorful themed splatters. Next, I use the metal borders to create grassy hills for the castle to stand on. I use both dyes to create different grassy hills. Since the cilantro cardstock is too bright and light for me, I use some Pine Needle Distress Oxide ink to create some depth and dimension. Both panels are also being splattered with water and Gunsign Tembi glitter paint. Next, I stamp my sentiment with my new stamping tool, the Misty. I'm so happy with it. I use Versamonk ink and white embossing powder and heat set the sentiment on guava cardstock. Then I cut my sentiment with my scissors and set them aside. Now I'm starting to set my scene on the card. For the most parts I used liquid glue since I wanted a flat card because more dimension will be too much on this card I think. As you can see, I like bold and colorful cards and I always use all the space there is on the card to create my scene. The story behind this card is as follows. The wizard has cast a spell on the prince. The ants want to save the prince, but on the way up, they are distracted by the candy the unicorns eat. They forgot to save the prince and eat the tasty sweets with the unicorns. So, I thought that story would be fun. Next it's time to add some embellishments on the card. I checked my stash and I saw that I had some purple stars and swirls. I end up using only the purple stars since it fits the most for the scene. Off camera I use some Spectrum Noir glitter pen and on camera I use some Nouveau Crystal glaze to create some shine. Then I also use some Nouveau Crystal White Blizzard for the horns of the unicorns. And that finishes off my card for today. I hope you like this card and like watching me creating this magical castle. If you like this video, please give me some thumbs up and subscribe to my YouTube channel. Click the notification bell so you don't miss any video of Creative Studio Nancy. Thank you so much for stopping by and I see you next time. Bye!